first stop on arrival in Washington, D.C. is the massive Washington Memorial. This monument stands 390 feet high. And right behind us is Abraham Lincoln's Memorial, which is housed in 36 columns that represent the number of states at the time. The massive Lincoln statue weighs 178 tons and is 19 feet high. He would be 28 feet tall if standing. We next visit the Arlington Cemetery, a sad place but beautifully maintained. John F. Kennedy, who was assassinated on the 22nd of November 1963, has these immortal words engraved on the walls of his tomb. Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Moving right along, we come to the White House, which is surrounded by steel railings, which are either to keep me out or the president in. We also visited the Smithsonian Institute Museum of Flight, where there's a fascinating collection of antique aircraft. Our next stop was the Natural History Museum, which has a collection of strange and exotic creatures. Leaving Washington, we now travel south. We take a quick look at the huge Chesapeake Bridge before making our way down to Kitty Hawk, which is the home of the Wright brothers at Killdevil's Hill. These very tasteful monuments record the last 100 years of major events in the history of flight, with Orville and Wilbur's first powered flight in 1903. It's amazing to think how much aviation has progressed in just over 100 years. These stone markers are positioned on the locations of the first flight. Number 1 was 120 feet, number 2 175 feet, number 3 200 feet, and then huge progress. Flight number 4 was 852 feet and lasted 59 seconds. Now that's almost as long as the queue at check-in. So we really have progressed in flight. Continuing south, we find ourselves in Carolina cotton country. When ripe, the cotton bud bursts and the soft springy material bursts out. It's no longer picked by hand, but these large combine harvester type machines collect the cotton, and then tractors and rotivators cut up the plants. This is a sparsely populated, very rural area with large lakes and strange trees with bearded moss hanging from the branches and abundance of birds and wildlife. Moving further south, we find the pace of life gets slower and slower. We tour the ancient city of Charleston in a 1-horsepower bus, and then stay a couple of nights at the Middleton Place It's a lovely restored plantation. Leaving Charleston, we have a very long road trip cross country to Memphis, Tennessee, where Elvis is still king. Graceland's was well worth the visit.
Well, I said, my baby, love me. And I found a new place to dwell. It was down at the end of Lonely Street. Heartbreak on the Elvis Street.
The Mercedes was a gift to his wife Priscilla. And apparently this John Deere tractor was his favorite vehicle. You must first pass through security before boarding Lisa Marie. It's now time to board the Queen of the Mississippi and start our long trip down the Mississippi River. Unfortunately, this replica paddle steamer is not run by steam, and neither does the paddle push you along. But never mind, it's still a lovely way to explore the history of the old muddy river, with its old plantation houses, the river's history, and gospel chapels along the way. Although there is no doubt the slaves had a terrible time, they still kept their traditions and music alive. We next called in at Vicksburg. This is the battlefield that in 1862 was the deciding conflict in the American Civil War. The war is long over and slavery is gone, but local music still plays an important part in the daily life of the Mississippi River. This cool dude rides the meanest of motorcycles. Back on board, we see a lot of river, a lot of boats, a lot of barges, but it's been a good trip. We visit many more plantations, see a load more history, and then end up at an ultra-modern cotton mill.
And or will be in a minute if it isn't. It comes down, it goes into this box press. Let's see what's happening with the box press, if it's working. An inspector who cuts out of the sides of each, cuts a knife blade into the side of each bale and weighs, checks it for.
Thankfully, things have moved on since the old days. The most distressing thing I saw was this valuation of slaves and their definitions, to think that these humans were treated as no more than a commodity. As we get nearer to New Orleans, we notice how much bigger the ships are, which can only mean we're nearing the end of our trip.